So I just wanted to cover this element of the film because I felt like it was very poignant in regards to bringing out the message. And basically, this just goes to show you that, you know, we're living in the last days, because everything that's coming to the forefront is heightened in regards to wickedness. So, you know, with this element, as far as in the film or the miniseries, when they see us, they decided to add the transgender element, in which they try to make it seem as if it's something that should be palatable, with the whole psychological element to it, where the mother is chastising the son because he elected to want to be a female. And, you know, you look at this with a spiritual eye and you understand that they always try to demonize the logical point, and they always try to extol the irrational point. And all that does is causes more confusion. And you know, art imitates life. So what you see in these movies and so on and so forth is a reflection of what goes on in life. But in this society, they push this agenda of transgenderism and feminism and so on and so forth on the masses. And they do it in these movies and in these TV series. Like, I'm under the impression that, you know, in certain parts of this movie, it was kind of like spiced up, you know, to make it seem more than what it is as far as the drama aspect. And it was so emotional watching it. It was too emotional. Like, it was too much somber, sobby elements to it. You feel what I'm saying? Like, I remember one scene where the dude was doing the push-ups because he had came to terms with just, you know, not having to go to the parole hearing, because he would have to just say the same thing in regards to them asking him if he would admit to the crime and him saying, nah, I didn't do it. And he said, you know, if they don't want to hear my truth. Like, when you hear that term, my truth, that's something that's new. Like, you wasn't hearing that 20 years ago, as far as people saying, nobody was saying this is my truth. Like, they added that in that because that's rhetoric that's a part of this progressive millennial, you know, line of thinking. You feel what I'm saying? Where it's like nobody cares about the truth. All we care about is our feelings. You feel what I'm saying? Because you could say your truth, but the truth is just the truth. It's not your truth, my truth, his truth. And I'm not saying that in reference to what the brother said, because we already know what he was talking about, because it is the truth, like, as far as with him. I'm just saying in regards to the world that we live in, where you hear that from a lot of people, oh, my truth. No, it's what the truth is. You feel what I'm saying? Like, and that's the world we live in. To the point where, you know, you have all these people who connect themselves with these ideologies and they don't even understand that it's self-defeating. So when you look at a scene where you got the mother chastising her son because she made a decision that was based in, you know, irrationale or immorality. And, you know, it's one of those things where when you look at it from a spiritual perspective, you understand what the message is as far as what's being conveyed. You know, when you read the book of Isaiah, it tells you in 5 and 20, you know, they call evil good and good evil. The things that we look at as evil are good things, as far as like what's known to be evil, in the eyes of the Lord in regards to this immorality in this society where they push all these agendas. You know what I mean? And I wanted to get Isaiah 5 and 20 real quick because it's very important. We're going to go into the scene, but I just wanted to get this scripture real quick because it's very important to get into it. So it says, woe unto them that call evil good and good evil, that put darkness for light and light for darkness, that put bitter for sweet and sweet for bitter. And that's the society, man, where the righteous is looked at as evil. You know, they call most of these Israelite camps hate groups. And all they're doing is telling you what's going on in the scriptures. All they're doing is bringing forth utterances that are of the Heavenly Father via the scriptures. That's all they're doing. And that's all I'm doing. I'm not saying anything that's out of my own mind. I'm giving you what's written in the manuscripts from ancient history. You know what I mean? Like, the Bible is not a book of religion. That's the biggest misconception in the whole world. Religion came into the forefront in 325 AD during the Council of Nicaea. The term religion goes back to the Greek word religia, which means to bind or hold back. When you're a religion, you're holding back from the truth. That's why a lot of these religions or what you call dogmas or denominations, they're popularized. Because when you're of the truth, it's not popular. That's why it's only a remnant of people that understand. You know what I mean? A lot of people are going to understand. They're going to continue to be confounded and confused, not understanding what the truth is in this society. So I just wanted to touch on this. Let's look at this real quick. We're going to go into a few more scriptures, but I just wanted to touch on this and look at this scene real quick. So let's check it out.
So remind me of that time I put you skipped in school. Remember that?
Remember that?
Court!
Hey, big bro.
Don't hate big bro. Me, you're supposed to be in school, man.
I know.
Give me some of these chips.
I'm worried about you, Court.
Why?
When you were a little kid, do you remember what you told me you wanted to be?
Yeah, I remember.
What?
A police officer, because I like the uniform.
How ironic.
Most kids thought I wanted to be a doctor, teacher, football player, police, whatever. But when they don't learn the discipline it takes, they end up doing a job they hate. Or worse, they end up on the street. You want to end up flipping burgers forever or begging people to let you sleep on their sofa?
No. I want a good life.
Guess what? Guess what?
What?
You can do it.
Right. How come whenever I always look at you like that?
You're blind to beauty, baby boy. That's all. Blind.
And that rhetoric is nonsense. They're blind. No, they're looking at you because they see you as something that's abnormal because you need help. If you are a boy, you are supposed to live according to the assumption that you're a boy. You're supposed to assume the position of boyhood until you grow into a man. If you're a boy and you're telling yourself that you're a girl, then you have a psychological imbalance. That's what it is. It's a psychological imbalance to be a faggot, a tranny, or anything that's contrary to the Heavenly Father when it comes to you having a sexual identity disorder. This shit is wrong, but they put it in these movies to make it palatable to the masses and look at it as something that they should be, that they should follow. Like, you know what? It's okay for him to feel like he's a girl. That's his truth. It's okay. No, man. It's not okay. It's self-defeating. Do you know how influential kids are? You know how feeble their minds are? So when you implant their minds with these ideologies, it makes it easier for them to latch onto them. It's dangerous, man. It's dangerous. It's just as bad as a kid being raised by two homos. That's not good. We need to look at these things as something that's immoral and wicked and stay away from them instead of praising them.
They praise homos for being homos in the month of June. But do they praise normal people for being normal? You know? Like, this shit is ridiculous, man. It's ridiculous. And it just goes to show you the type of world that we're living in where everything is contrary to the Most High and it's amplified. Righteousness is frowned upon in this society. Wickedness is exalted. You could be a tranny and you're a superhero. Look at Bruce Jenner. Or Caitlyn Jenner or whatever the fuck the person name is. Like, the person was given an award, a courage award, for being a fucking tranny. And I like the element that Eva Duverney put in this movie, because they know deep down inside that this shit is wrong, but they try to utilize these tactics to make it seem as if the logic is wrong and the irrational is right. Meaning the logic of the mother telling her son that she's a real woman, that's wrong for saying I'm a real woman. You're not a real woman, because you're not. You were born with a penis. If you believe that you're a woman, then that means you have a mental illness and you need to go see somebody. But in this society, the power structure, because they want people to feel this way, they implore them to embrace it. And that's why everything is all upside down and everything is based in confusion. A lot of people might not like what I'm about to say right now, but that was judgment. That was judgment from the Most High. That's what that was. That was judgment.
Get the fuck out of my house!
You think I want to fucking be here?
I don't know where you want to be!
But where you fighting about now?
Your brother belongs in a crazy house. Your brother wants to be your sister.
And... you know, this scene really touches on the truth as far as, you know, the aspect of logic versus irrational, where the logic is basically, you know, the evil side and the irrational is the good side. And that's pursuant to Isaiah 5 and 20, where it's like the woman, like the mother, she's telling the truth. There was nothing in this scene that she said that wasn't of any truth. Because these people are bugged out. They twisted. And they need help. You cannot strive in a society with that illness. It's wrong. You can't live up to how the Creator created you. So you decide that you want to be something other than what you're not. But in this world, which is governed by Lucifer, these things, these sentiments are wrong as far as, you know, you telling a person that they're bugged out for them thinking that they're something that they're not and them wanting to get a sex change. You're wrong if you tell a woman not to abort her fetus. You're wrong if you tell a woman not to get ass shots or boob shots. It's crazy, man. It's fucking crazy, bro.
Your fucking sister. You crazy. You're sick.
I'm leaving.
Don, I'm leaving.
Why? Don't go. Mad, because I won't let him rip and run in and up out of here looking any old kind of way. Look at him. You're a fucking joke. And everybody is laughing at you in your face and behind your back. Girl, you know I ain't lying. But I'm done with it. I'm done losing businesses and friends and everything because of your twisted ass. Go! My house, Norman. Marcy, okay? It's Marcy.
You were born with the name Norman. Your name is Norman. Your name is not Marcy. This is how you know that this shit is a psychological imbalance. They promote this shit as if it's something that's normal. It's not normal. It's not normal. It's wrong. It's wrong, man.
Fuck you ever hear me call you that. Ever. Norman. 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 Norman.
Norman, let's talk it out. Let's talk it out. It's not nothing to talk about. I'm done. You are a sad woman, mama. Sad.
And you know, that kind of rhetoric is like, it's open-ended. Is she sad for telling you the truth? How is she sad? That's vague. Like, and that's the rhetoric that you see with these people when you tell them about themselves. Oh, you just don't understand me. You don't know about the love. Like, it's not, what type of nonsense is that, man? Come on, man. Come on, man. It's crazy, man.
Don't you fix your mouth to tell me what I am. You don't know me. You don't know nothing about being me. Because you got on my shit, you think you know me? What you know about being a mother with no help? With nobody but yourself to depend on?
I know you're sad, Mama. And I know nobody made you that way.
And I didn't make you say you did that to yourself. Miss me with the psychoanalysis, huh? You dealing out the fucking house.
Exactly. Miss me with the psychoanalysis, all that nonsense. You a fucking man and you got on a wig and makeup and shit. And we could hear the tone of your voice and how deep it is. It's not normal, man. It's not normal. It's something that you look at and you just... You have a great disdain for because the shit is just, it's distasteful. It makes you want to fucking throw up. You see a 6'3 man walking down a fucking street with a name like Peaches. And you got kids. And you got to tell them about what the fuck that is. But these people, they get exalted in this society. Normal people don't get exalted. They don't have a fucking month that's dedicated to heterosexual people. It's Pride Day, Pride Month. Having pride and being fucking wicked. That's the fucking world we live in. It's disgusting. It's fucking disgusting, man. Straight up. It's disgusting. And they really had the nerve to put this in the movie. But it's good that they put this in the movie or miniseries or whatever you want to call it. It's good that they put this in here. Because I'm able to use it as a backdrop to edify people on the wickedness of this world that we live in.
Shut up! You shut
And that's what the hell she is. Straight up demon. Let's get another scripture real quick before we close it out. We're going to put this on airplane mode so we won't get distracted by anything as far as text messages or calls, because sometimes I get distracted and I don't need nobody in my business. So we're going to go to Isaiah. I believe it's Isaiah 16 and 28. Or maybe it's 28 and 16. What scripture is it? I know it's in the book of Isaiah. Hold on, you guys. We're going to have to Google it because I forget the scripture, unfortunately. So Isaiah 29 and 16. That's what it is. I'm tripping. Isaiah 29 and 16. Where it says, surely your turnings of things upside down shall be esteemed as the potter's clay. Meaning, as far as the ideologies that we see in this society with the self-defeating ideologies, everything being turned upside down in regards to things that we see as bad, but they promote it as good, and things that we see as good, but they promote it as bad. That's not going to be for so long. You know what I mean? That's not going to last but for so long, because destruction is coming, and you have to have trauma and destruction in order for things to change. So these things will change, but you have to have a great recompense based off of the conduct of us on the earth. You know what I mean? So that's why it says, surely your turnings of things upside down shall be esteemed as the potter's clay. And who's turning these things upside down? The people who promote these agendas. The power structure in which they tell these executives and these producers, these directors, these media companies, these media outlets to promote this stuff. So they turn these things upside down because they want the world to be confused and confounded, because this is Babylon. This is Sodom and Gomorrah. This is ancient Egypt all over again. That's what it is. So it says, for shall the work say of him that made it, he made me not? Exactly. Exactly. Pursuant to this transgender person. Or shall the thing frame say of him that framed it, he had no understanding? So it's very important for us to understand what time it is and what they're trying to, you know, shove down our throats in regards to these agendas. So I just wanted to touch on that. I hope you guys have a blessed day, blessed morning, and blessed night. All right. Shalom.